So we are going to start with a few words from the director of the OSBI, Angela Spurlock.
Good morning. I appreciate you all coming today. As Hunter said, my name is Angela Spurlock, the director for the Oklahoma State Bureau of Investigation. As you all know, we have been working very diligently for the last 2 weeks to bring closure to the families. This has been challenging for everybody involved. This case did not end the way we had hoped. It has certainly been a tragedy for everybody involved. The mission of the OSBI, though, is to protect Oklahoma one partnership at a time, and certainly this case is an example of how those partnerships work and how it takes everybody coming together to bring resolution. And so while I am very grateful for all of my agents that have worked since the very beginning, 24 hours a day, to get us to the point we are today, we could not have reached where we're at without the partnerships of the Texas County Sheriff's Office, the District 1 District Attorney's Office, without our FBI partners, and without the assistance of the Oklahoma Medical Examiner's Office and the Oklahoma Highway Patrol that could not be here. So our condolences go out to the family, and we will continue to update you as we continue to move this investigation forward. And now I'm going to now turn it over to our FBI partners. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Sonia Garcia. I am acting special agent in charge for the Oklahoma City Field Office, FBI. On behalf of the entire FBI, I want to express our sincerest condolences to the family and loved ones of Veronica and Jillian. The FBI was requested to assist on this matter on April 4th, and since then, we've had a dedicated team of analysts, agents, evidence response, and tactical personnel working around the clock and alongside with OSBI and Texas County Sheriff's Office to bring the individuals responsible for this crime into custody, and to provide a sense of closure to the families and to this community. Know that we are grieving with you today. We will continue to work with our partners and to be an advocate for Jillian and Veronica and to ensure that justice will be served. Thank you.
My name is Matt Bowley. I am the Sheriff of Texas County. I would also like to offer our condolences to the family. My agency's role in this is that we received a call on March 30th of an abandoned vehicle with persons missing from the vehicle. Deputies immediately responded to the area. When they arrived on scene, they found some things that just weren't adding up, so we established a crime scene and then notified the OSBI to have them come and assist us with this and to actually take lead on the case. We established a search party made up of the Gunman Fire Department and several of the volunteer fire departments in the county. And we searched the area around the crime scene for about a mile in each direction. Once the OSBI arrived on the scene, they took the lead and got us to this point where we are today. I'd like to thank the Oklahoma State Bureau of Investigation, especially the Northwest region. They were phenomenal in this. The Federal Bureau of Investigation, the Oklahoma Highway Patrol, Gunman Fire Department, several Kansas agencies that assisted, local agencies here in Texas County that assisted, and I'm sure I've forgotten a few, but I'd like to just say thank you, even to the public. There was a lot of questions from the public, as was there any danger to the public? And I think from the get-go, once we arrived on scene, that and we gained a little bit of information, that we felt this wasn't a random bill. All right, we felt that with some of the information coming in, that it was more targeted, and we started to look in those areas that we were pointed to. Okay, thank you.
I'm George Harrison Weeks III. I'm the district attorney for District 1. I wanted to start to let you know that on Friday the informations were filed, and they were filed under seal. The reason they were filed under seal was to protect our law enforcement officers and to try to keep the children out of harm's way. We were successful. No shots were fired, and the children were kept out of harm's way. Our district judge issued an order this morning, and those files are now unsealed. So you can get the information at the courthouse, you can get the affidavits at the courthouse, which will give you the facts that we were working off of. Additionally, I would like to, this has been an amazing enterprise. Reading on social media, some of the stuff, and there were people out there that thought law enforcement was asleep, that they weren't doing anything. There were even additional law enforcement agencies, the Kansas Bureau of Investigation, Dallin County Sheriff's Office, Sherman County Sheriff's Office from the state of Texas. Everybody came together and everybody helped. We're probably talking somewhere in the neighborhood of 100 law enforcement officers. Truly, no exaggeration, working night and day for 15 days. I want to thank the public. We have people calling us from North Texas Panhandle, from the Oklahoma Panhandle, from Southwest Kansas, providing us information, responding because they cared. And the information we received from them was critical. Also want to thank corporate America. I don't know how many search warrants we issued, and I'm telling you, they responded in lightning speed. Anything we needed, any order we sent, we got everything that we needed. Lastly, I'd like to thank all the law enforcement agencies that came together and worked together as a team, and all their personnel. They did a fantastic job. Thank you.
Any additional questions you guys have, go right on ahead.
Is there confirmation at this point that the bodies recovered are Joanne and Ronnie?
Not at this time. We have, we identified that there were two bodies during our search. Both of those deceased persons have been transported to the Oklahoma Medical Examiner's Office, where they will do a proper identification and also look into a cause and manner of death.
What led to the discovery of the bodies?
Based on the evidence that our agents and local law enforcement were able to obtain, we used that to search a wide area throughout Texas County, and we were able to use those resources in order to find where these two bodies were.
Do you know the timeline for when the bodies should be identified and when we should know what the cause of death was?
It's a case-by-case basis, but as soon as we hear back from the Oklahoma Medical Examiner's Office, we will let the public know.
Can you describe the scene where these bodies were recovered and what state these remains are in?
No, I mean, I can say that it was a very rural area. I cannot state the condition of the bodies.
Is this private property?
I cannot confirm that at this time.
In Oklahoma, there's the death penalty. If convicted, could we possibly maybe see this in this case?
You would have to reach out to the district attorney's office. That'll be something that will be discussed further down the line.
D.A. Stewart alluded to a lot of people calling in with a lot of tips. Were there particular tips that broke this case?
We received several tips throughout this entire process. The public, I mean, I know that we had thanked that our local law enforcement agencies, what they were able to help us and throughout this search, but the people here throughout this area have done a tremendous job of reaching out to us. The original press release that we had put out on March 31st, in regards to searching for these two women, we constantly received several tips. and had used those throughout the entire 14-day process in order to find these two bodies, and then also discover and find those who were responsible for this crime.
So the reason foul play was suspected was because of evidence found in the car. Can you go into more detail now of what that evidence was?
We cannot still at this time. It is still an ongoing investigation, and that is for our investigative purposes. Again, we can say that the evidence that was discovered inside of that abandoned vehicle and around it, we're able to help our investigators determine that there was foul play involved, and then led to the progression of this investigation. What was in the vehicle around it, we cannot discuss.
It was quite a convoy in executing these four search warrants. Was there concern of resistance to arrest? How much concern was there over a possible gunfight?
When you are regarding arrests and multiple arrests in the magnitude that we have all discussed, there is always, there is always a cause of, of trying to protect the public as best you possibly can. We can say that all four of those arrests were made without incident, and so that, of course, went extremely well, and we are extremely grateful. Another agency that wasn't able to make it that was a big part of that and helped us tremendously was the Oklahoma Highway Patrol. So we want to thank them tremendously on that. But I mean, again, there was concern, but we are extremely thankful that no one was hurt, no one was injured during this process.
Did any of the four suspects charged in the case tell law enforcement where to find them?
Say that one more time.
Did any of the four suspects charged in the case tell law enforcement where to find them?
No, we cannot discuss that at this time.
How early did you guys have suspects?
We can't discuss that.
Are you able to go into further detail how you believe that this was targeted and not a random act?
Based on the evidence and the information that we were able to obtain throughout the entire investigation, what was found inside of the vehicle, witnesses, family, friends of the victims that we were able to talk to throughout this entire process, we were able to gain the information to determine that that these four people were responsible for both of these women going missing.
Also, are you able to confirm if this was over a custody battle?
We cannot confirm that at this time.
What's the relationship, if any, between the suspects and Veronica and Billy?
Again, because it is still an ongoing investigation, we cannot discuss that.
We know that one arrest was in Texas County, the three others in Cimarron. Can you describe the arrest process? You said there was no resistance, but...
That's all we can really say at this time. And we can say that the four people that we were looking for were found, arrested, and placed into custody within the same day, and there was no resistance.
And obviously you can't talk about the evidence in this case, but is there significant physical evidence in this investigation?
Yes.
Can you elaborate?
No.
Are you able to go into the condition of the bodies that were found?
No.
Is there a reason you guys were so tight-lipped right off the start? You said there wasn't a threat to the public when you guys were investigating, but still not a lot of information was released. Is there a reason for that?
There was not immediate threat to the public. Again, as the sheriff alluded, this was a targeted case. And when you ask about us not releasing a lot of information in that two-week process, this is the way that our investigators work. This is what you have to do in order to get the job done, everybody involved, in order to catch those responsible and do everything in our power to find both of these people who went missing from the very beginning. So again, as we try to do as the investigation progresses, we can release as much details as we possibly can. But again, the way that this process works is you can't give away as much as maybe you guys are asking for, because that's how we're able to catch these four suspects.
Did law enforcement speak with Tiffany Adams on March 30th?
I cannot confirm that.
Was the property where the bodies were found connected to the suspects at all?
I cannot confirm that.
Was Kelly a court-appointed supervisor for Butler's business with her children?
I can't go into that.
So I know the bodies haven't been identified, but, everyone expressed their condolences. Do you think there's any chance that Veronica and Jillian are still alive?
No.
Any word on arraignment?
We will look into that further. When that is made available, we will let everybody know.
As the investigation progresses, do you expect the possibility for more suspects to be arrested?
Not at this time.
Have the suspects been cooperative and talkative, or have they provided any type of confessions?
We cannot release that at this time.
Have the families helped you guys during this process at all? Have you guys worked
Yes.
with them? What's that been like?
Families, friends, people that have known both of these women who went missing have been a tremendous help. Everybody that we have talked to has helped us tremendously in doing everything they can to give us the necessary information in order for us to try to track them down and find out what happened.
Where are the children?
We can't go into that right now.
Are they safe?
Yes.
Children are safe.
We can't go into that.
Now that the FBI is involved, will they face any federal charges?
We're not going to go into that right now.
So what next? Is there going to be further investigation?
Yes, the investigation continues. The next steps are when the identification of the two victims is made, we will let everyone know. And when the cause and manner of death is made by the medical examiner's office, we will let everyone know.
Were the bodies together?
We cannot confirm that. Right now, there are no suspects at large. The public is not in danger. That's what's important to us. We are extremely grateful that we were able to locate and arrest the four people that we believe are responsible for this crime. As soon as the identification is made with the bodies, we will let everyone know. But again, it took everybody in this case to get this done. We know that there were people throughout the two-week process who were frustrated, who wanted answers as soon as possible. You know, we wanted those answers too, but just know that our OSBI agents, FBI agents, troopers, Kansas Bureau of Investigation, the KHP, everybody worked nonstop in order to come together and make these arrests.
Can you talk at all about the relationship between...
No, we can't go into that right now.
Was there ever any concern for the children at any point in this investigation? Like for their safety?
There's always concern whenever there's children involved, but we can say that the children are safe.
With this being such a rural area, did this make this case unique in any ways?
It made it challenging. Again, you're talking about northern Texas County, near that Kansas line. It's very rural. Those of you in the media that have been up there covering this, not a lot of homes, not a lot of buildings or businesses. Sometimes you could use cameras to help you in this case. We did not have that. So that's what made it extremely challenging.
Is there any video evidence?
Not at this time.
Have you ever seen a case like this? Is there anything different about it?
The OSBI covers all kinds of cases. Each case is different in their own way. They're all just as important to us. But, you know, this case was tragic. You have two people who are dead, and four people that committed an absolutely brutal crime. And so, again, that's why it took every agency involved in this in order to get this done.